Stay home. Save lives.
Hello children. Today I am back with the continuation of the last video, that is exercise on numbers part 2. Let me remind you children that this is only a learning session. Copy work will be given to you later on through WhatsApp. So let's start with today's class. First I'll teach you the place value once again. Now before that children, I want you all to know what is a digit and what is a number. Now let me tell you what is a digit. Digit means 0 to 9 are digits. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 are digits. Now what is a number? A number is formed by digits. Now what is a number here? It can be a single digit, it can be a two digit number, it can be a three digit number and so on. So in this case, 6 is a single digit number, 32 is a two digit number and here 624 is a three digit number. Now children, tell me, how do you understand this number? I mean, we know that it's 462, but how do we look at it in terms of its digit? In every number, each digit you see has a place value and that depends entirely on where it is placed or positioned. So this number 462, here the digit 2 is in 1's place, the digit 6 is in 10's place and the digit 4 is in 100's place. For the number 462, how will you give the place value? Remember that you always start from the right side. 2 1's, 6 10's and 4 100's. So this means that 4 is in 100's place, 6 is in 10's place and 2 is in 1's place. The symbol for 1's is O, the symbol for 10's is T and symbol for 100's is H. Is it clear children? With the help of place value, let's try to break this number. As 4 lies in 100's place, we can write 4 times 100. As 6 is in the 10's place, we add 6 times 10 to this. And 2 is in the 1's place, we add 2 times 1. So this is how we break a number according to its place value. Now we'll come to the questions. The first question we have is, find the place value of the underlined digits. Here you have to determine the place value of the digit which is underlined. Now let's take some example. First one, 352. Now what is underlined here? Digit 2. So what is the place value of 2 here? 2 1's. Now the second one, 186. What is underlined here? 1. So what is the place value of 1 here? 100. Since it is 1, so we write here 100. Now the third one, 92. Now it is a two digit number. So what is underlined here? 9. So what is the place value of 9 here? 9 tens. Now the last one, 778. Now what is underlined here? Digit 7. So what is the place value of 7 here? 7 tens. I think it is clear to you all. Children, here are your practice questions. There are 3 questions. Pause the video and solve it yourself and then see the answer. Children, let's see the answers. The first one, 72. 2 is underlined here. So what is the answer here? 2 1's. Now let's see the second one, 156. Now what is underlined here? 1. So what is the answer? 100. Children, we write 100 because it is only 1. Now if it was 256, then we would have written 200s, not 100. So this is 100. Now the third one, 620. Now what is underlined here? 2. So what is the answer here?
two tens. Now we'll come to the next topic, that is expanded form. This is also related to the place value. Children, when you are asked to give the expanded form of a number, you are supposed to expand the number according to the place value of the digits of the number. For example, I'll take one number, 789. So how will you expand this number? 7 hundreds plus 8 tens plus 9 ones. So basically, here they are asking you how many hundreds are there in this number, how many tens are there, and how many ones are there. So how will you expand here? 7 hundreds plus 8 tens plus 9 ones. I'll give you some more example. The first one, 166. Now how many hundreds are there? 100. Children, remember that we'll write 100. It's not hundreds. So 100 plus 6 tens plus 6 ones. Now the second one, 32. Now since this is a two-digit number, so what is the place value of 3 here? Yes, exactly. 3 tens plus 2 ones. Children, I hope the expanded form is clear to you all. Now I'll give you some practice questions. These are your questions, 3 questions. Now try to do it yourself and then check for the answer. Children, I hope you all are ready with your answers. Now let's check the answer. The first one was 216. So how do you write? 2 hundreds plus 1 ten plus 6 ones. The second one, 542. So 5 hundreds plus 4 tens plus 2 ones. Now finally, 734. So how you'll write? 7 hundreds plus 3 tens plus 4 ones. Move on to the next topic, that is short form. In the previous question, you have learned to expand a number according to their place value. Now here, we are going to write the expanded numbers in a short form. For example, the first one, 3 hundreds plus 5 tens plus 9 ones. This is a 3-digit number. So how do you write? 359. Now the second one, 4 tens plus 3 ones. Now this is a 2-digit number. So how do you write? 4343. Now the third one, 100 plus 8 tens plus 6 ones. Now how you will write this number? 186. Children, these are your practice questions. The first one, 600 plus 2 tens plus 7 ones. The second one is 8 tens plus 9 ones. Now solve it yourself and then check for the answer. You all must have done it correctly. Now let's check the answer. The first one, 6 hundreds plus 2 tens plus 7 ones. So how do you write in short form? 627. The second one, 8 tens plus 9 ones. That means it's a 2-digit number. So how do you write this? 8989. We'll come to the last topic, that is abacus. Children, I have taught you how to read a number according to its place value. Now, I'm going to teach you how to represent a number on abacus according to its place value. So now, this is an abacus for 3-digit number and this is an abacus for 2-digit number. Now, if I ask you to represent a number, for example, 475, how will you represent on an abacus? It's very simple. First, you will draw the abacus like this. For a 3-digit number, you will draw the abacus with 3 spikes. Plot the place value like this. Hundreds, tens and ones. Now, you will write the numbers below its place value. Like, in hundreds, you will write 4, tens, you will write 7 and ones, you will write 5. The next step is to draw the beads according to the digits. Here the digit is 4. So you will draw 4 beads. Here the digit is 7. You will be drawing 7 beads. The next digit is 5. So you will be drawing 5 beads. I'll give you another example. 30. Now this is a 2-digit number. Now we'll draw the abacus with tens and ones. Now under tens we'll write 3 and under ones we'll write 0. Now according to the digits we'll draw the beads. Here 3 tens means 3 beads and 0 means no beads. We'll not draw any beads. Now children, these are your practice question. Note down the question. Make the abacus yourself and check for the answer. This is the way you will be making the abacus. The first one is 43. This is a 2-digit number, so you will make 2 spikes with tens and ones. For 4, you will be making 4 beads, and 3 ones means 3 beads. Now let's see the second one. 215. It's a 3-digit number, so you will be making 3 spikes with hundreds, tens and ones. So 200 means 2 beads. 110 means 1 bead and 5 ones means 5 beads.
You all have enjoyed today's class. That was the end of lesson number 2, that is exercise on numbers. So far, I have taught you 2 lessons, that is tables and exercise on numbers. So now we have finished the syllabus for April, that is PT1, lesson number 1 and 2. So now I want you all to practice more and more sums based on numbers and memorize the tables. Thank you, children. God bless.